dumb shit, man. Stupidest thing my dad ever did when he was on drugs, right? When I was a kid, I remember my dad came to parent-teacher conference. That's when you go to your kid's school, talk to your teacher, see how they're doing in the school. My dad shows up with sweatpants on with no drawers. This nigga dick was all over the place, okay? Listen, I cannot make this up. Let me show y'all how my dad walked into my school. This is all I saw. Hey! Every time he stopped, his dick kept moving. Excuse me! I can hear little girls like, ew! Ew! My dad got mad. What the fuck is you illing about? You ain't never seen nobody with a long dick! Hey, Dad, don't say that.
You gonna learn today. You gonna learn what a long dick look like today.
No, Dad, she don't need to learn that, please. Now, I'm not spiteful like my dad. My dad is very spiteful. Like, my dad gets mad. Like, I remember him and my mom would argue, right? No matter what he bought in the house, he would take with him when he left. I don't give a fuck what it was. Like, if you were cooking a steak in the pan, and my dad bought it when he left, bitch, get the goddamn steak out the pan. What we gonna eat? Bitch, put the steak in my hand. I'm ready to go. We'll put a hot steak in his hand. But, bitch, put it in the bag. Fucking crazy. I remember my dad took all the Christmas lights off the Christmas tree on Christmas Eve. Do you know how mad you gotta be to take the Christmas lights off the goddamn Christmas tree? Do you know how long it takes to take the Christmas lights off the fucking Christmas tree? And to keep an attitude that whole time?
Yep. Y'all done fucked up today. Too late. Too late. It's gonna be a dark Christmas in this bitch, I bet you that. Ain't nobody gonna see shit in this house. How many sets of lights I put on this goddamn Christmas tree?
That was fucking crazy. Here's the thing with talking dirty. I can say dirty shit, I just don't like it when you say stuff back. Because when you say stuff back, then I gotta say something back to what you just said. It's too much. Shut up. So let me say what I gotta say. That's too fucking much. That's the worst. Like, fellas, you ever say some real good shit to a girl, she say something back too quick? You don't got no response for it. I ain't the only man in here that's been stumped. Every man in here has been stumped. When you say some good shit, yeah, you like this dick, don't you? Oh, what I like about it. I don't know. I didn't expect you to say what you said when you said it. I thought you were going to let me keep going because I had some other stuff I wanted to say. So let's just stop. I want to write some stuff down so I can. It's no big deal. Whatever. You ever have a girl roll your drawers down when you didn't expect it? Hey, baby. Hey! Look on the ground, your drawers being that panty ball. That fucking... Bitch, that's a pair of boxers. You better extend it by punching in the fucking throat. Got my shit looking like a balled up thong on the fucking floor. Girl, I'll chop you on your goddamn neck. I'm just being honest. Now, ladies, I know what you're thinking. You're like, Kevin, you don't like all this stuff about us. I'm quite sure some stuff that we don't like about you. You're absolutely right. I'll tell you what you don't like about me. I don't have sex for very long. I'm not playing. You got about a good 20 to 23 seconds with me, ladies, and I'm very serious. I'm serious. Here's the thing. I don't care. I come quick. Whatever. It is what it is. Fellas, if you come fast, embrace it. Be good in that amount of time. All you got to do is disguise it. Put a girl in a lot of positions. That's what I do. I put you in like 9 positions in 23 seconds. I'm not playing. You don't believe me? Okay. All right. Watch this. I'm going to fuck the shit out this stool for 23 seconds. You brought this on yourself. Don't make me laugh. This is serious shit. Shut the fuck up. You're about to get it. Go!
You all right? You want some juice?
That's how you know when you ain't do shit, when you want some juice. When a man asks you, do you want some juice? He know his dick wasn't shit. You want some juice?
I'm going to the kitchen. I get you some juice. You want some juice? You want me to make you some juice? I can make you some juice from scratch.
Fellas, you ever get that hump in your back? You know what that is? You ever get that turtle shell? So you come too hard. That shit right there. That turtle shell. Your head going in and out the shell.
Shit.
I've been in the clubs. I've been on the scene. I see what's going on. Do I like the clubs? No. Do I like the single lives? Not really. But I'm in it. Reason why I go to clubs, because my friends make me. Because they can't get in without me. So I have to go. Here's the thing, I'm gonna tell you what shocked me the most about the clubs. I didn't know that that dancing shit, like that whole dance battle shit, I didn't know that that was real. Like, I thought it was just on TV, like with dance crews. That shit is real. Like grown ass men be battling, like face to face. Grown ass fucking men. The shit that make me laugh the most, like, when you watch people battle, is the dude that be calling the dancers out. He say shit you have no clue, like you never knew this was going on. Oh shit, that nigga in your house. He walking your dog. Where the fuck he get the dog? When he get the dog? I got involved in one dance battle. One dance battle. I go to a club, right? I'm with my boy Spank. Now here's the thing, Spank can dance. Spank can dance his ass off. Personally, I think Spank a little too tall to do some of the dances he does. Spank like 6'5". Shouldn't do some of them, but whatever. It's his business. We go into a club. Spank walking in front of me. I'm behind him, right? When we get there, he hear a song. He's like, oh, shit. This is my song. He dropped his ass down twice. Bop. Bop. Now, here's the thing. I'm right behind him. I'm small. His ass hit my lip a little bit. Not a lot, but it definitely... I was like, no. The DJ was like, oh shit, them niggas dirty whining. No, we're not. Don't do that. Don't say that. Don't put that message out there. I said, hey man, don't fucking do that shit in front of me. Go out there and dance if you want to dance. He said, all right, cool. He go out there on the dance floor. He see this girl. He start dancing. He ain't doing nothing crazy. He's just two-stepping. Him and the girl dancing. Out of nowhere, this guy walks up. He got like 5 guys with him, right? He grabbed the girl. He looked at Spank. He said, hey, man, you don't want this fucking problem. Now, in my mind, I said, oh, shit, we about to fight. So I did what I do. I took a beer bottle. I broke it because I was about to stab this bitch in the face. I'm lying. I tried to break it. It didn't break, so I sat down. Listen, whatever. That has nothing to do with the story. It's neither here nor there. Okay. So I sit down. I'm looking, right? This is shit that was wild. When the guy moved the girl, he said, yeah, you don't want this fucking problem. Out of nowhere, he was like, yeah. Now, this is shit that made me laugh. When he was doing this, right, his friends behind him was like, oh. I was like, what the fuck is that? What's going on? What the hell is this? So he grabbed Spank's chest. When he grabbed his chest, he was like, yeah, what I got? Now, the bitch in me came out. I was like, what is it? What's in his hand? What does he have? He said, I got your heart, nigga. I got your fucking heart. I'm about to eat it. He said, yeah, I ate it, bitch. Ooh, it's nasty. Threw it back up. He said, take it back. Hit Spank on the head. Spank came back to life. Because technically, Spank was dead for like 32 seconds because the guy had his heart. So when he gave it back, I was like, yo, Spank, we should leave because next time he might not be that nice. He might not give it back. So Spank was like, yo, man, fuck that. He want to battle. Let's battle. I said, Spank, it's 5 of them, okay? You're not going to do it by yourself. Tag me in. He said, what? I said, tag me in. Hit my hand. I'm going to go here. I'm going to bring it right back here, okay? Just hit my hand. I'm going to go here with it. I'm going to bring it right back here. He said, no, Kev, fuck that. I got him. I'm about to get in the car on this bitch. I said, what? He said, I'm about to get in the car on his ass. I said, whatever. Fine. Do you. He said, when I get to the other side of the room, throw me the car keys. I said, my real car keys? He said, bitch, throw me the keys. I said, okay. I'm not going to argue with you. Whatever. Fine. Okay. So Spank start dancing. He gets to the other side of the room. He going off, right? He said, Kev, I'm at the car. Throw me the keys. I take out my car keys. I throw them hard as shit. When I throw them, this bitch ducks. When he ducks, hit the glass behind the bar. All the glass break. Alcohol fall down. The bartender looked at me. He said, you going to have to pay for this shit. I said, I would, but the way that my bank account now is set up.